in the wool production, that the wool should be clean and processed, and then we make wool from it. So the whole process is called wool production. Okay, in the first figure, the person is removing fleece or hair from the body of the sheep. Yes, so this process is called shearing. Okay, the process of removal of hair or fur from any animal is called shearing. Okay, anyone knows this removing of hair or sheep is harmful or beneficial for the sheep? Yes, Dhruv. Ma'am, please unmute Dhruv.
Ma'am, it would be harmful because it can cause injuries to the sheep.
Yes, but in summers, Dhruv, it yes. In summers, if we talk about summers, you know,
in summers,
okay, I will clear you this thing that it is also beneficial for the sheep, because in summers, this wool, the hair that are present on the body can trap so much heat. Okay, so the sheep will feel hot in summers. So it is beneficial for the sheep also to remove this fur or hair from its body. Okay, the machine that is that the person is using is similar to that the barber use. Okay, so you in the step one you have to, there is written in bold shearing, you have to tick these lines. The fleece of the sheep along with the thin layer of it is removed from the body. This process is called shearing. Okay, so this fur that is obtained from sheep is then converted into fiber. Okay, then from that fiber woolen yarn is made. Okay, and then yarn is converted into fabric to make a woolen fabric. Okay, you are getting my point? The shearing is useful for the sheep. I am repeating again, because in summers the sheep will feel hot, so it is beneficial for them. Okay, have you seen your father shaves his beard with the help of any razor? Yes, so it is, the machine is similar to that. There is also chance that the razor also cause any wound. Yes, so in the similar way it is useful for the sheep also. Now next is step 2. Now this fur is removed from the body of the sheep. We have to now wash that fur because it includes so many dust and dirt. What we do, we'll take in the previous years, what the people do, they take tanks, then fill them with water, then pour the whole fur into it and then wash it. Okay, so the process by which shorn hair is washed to get rid of dust, dirt and grease is called scoring. It is the second step. First is shearing and second is scoring. Nowadays we also use machines, but in the previous time when there are no machines, people use tank filled with water to wash the hair or fur. Okay, so that it can remove the whole dust. Now next is sorting. What do you mean by sorting? Sorting means separation. Okay, for example, you also separate your books, copies, pens are placed on different place. Yes, similarly, wool is also sorted. That means the process of separating and grouping wool according to its feature. Means के black जो color वाली wool है वो एक तरफ कर देनी है, white वाली एक तरफ कर दी, ठीक है, जो soft है उसको एक तरफ कर दिया. You are getting my point? And that is rough and hard, it is placed on the other side. This is called sorting. Okay. Now, this sorting can be done on the basis of length, color, texture, ability, and to get dyed. Sometimes क्या होता है कि वो जो wool है वो बहुत जल्दी dye हो जाती है, कई wool dye इतनी जल्दी नहीं होती है. What do you mean by dyed? To give color to the wool. Okay? It is dyed. So the next is, sorting is clear to you all, that we have to separate and group and make the group of the wool. Now next is drying. So when we wash the whole fur in water, then the next step is to dry it. What we will do? We will dry it with the help of either machines. Okay, so there the first term that is written is burrs. What is burrs? The small fluffy fibers. These are the small fluffy fibers that you have also seen on the sweaters. Okay. Fibers are scored again and dried. उनको जो है जो fluffy fibers है उनको अलग एक तरफ कर दिया जाता है और फिर से dry किया जाता है. So then the wool is ready to made from fibers. आपने जो fibers है एक तरफ कर दिया, उनको dry कर दिया, अब फिर आपकी जो fibers आपने collect किए हैं अब उनसे जो है wool बनेगी, ठीक है ना. Now it is clear to you all. You have to tick the definition of scoring also in the step 2 and sorting also. I have explained both definitions. In the step 4, blurs. What are blurs? ये भी आपको पता होना चाहिए. Now next is step 5. The step 5 is dyeing. That you have to color the wool. Okay, what is dyeing? The process of coloring the wool. Okay, why we have to color? Because the wool is naturally it is available in only 3 colors: white, brown, and black. Okay, we have to give colors. The wool is available in market in different colors: blue, black, red, yellow. Okay, it is dyed. Yes, then you have to give color to the wool. So then. You have given color to the wool also. Now next is rolling into yarn. What you get is fibers. Okay, when the fibers are twisted, for example, it is a wool fiber. What is fiber? See here, Dhruv. It is a single fiber. It is a wool fiber. I will show you the example. Any wool fabric, it is an example only. It is made up of fiber. Okay, so the single fiber that is very thin is called a fiber. Okay, then how a yarn is made? When we twist, for example, I am taking 2 fibers. Okay, these are the 2 fibers. I will twist it to form yarn. These are the 2 fibers, na? You are able to see? Then I will twist them to form yarn. Okay, from this yarn, we will made a fabric. From fiber we made yarn, then we made fabric. Okay. अब देखिए, there are long fibers also and short fiber also. That the long fibers that are very long, we use it to form sweaters. Okay, the very long threads that are obtained during the process, we use it to form sweaters. But the very small, the short fibers are spun, means ke unko kata jata hai, katna. What do you mean by spun? And then woven into woolen cloth. Then we weave it into the, to prepare woolen cloth. What do you mean by weave? The two sets of yarn and threads are arranged together in a such a manner to make a cloth. Okay, what do you mean by weaving? The two sets of yarn or thread are arranged together in a pattern to make a cloth. You are getting my point? Now Now next is, then I will sum up the whole process at the end of the session. Now we will discuss about the health hazards in wool production. Now, wool production is a very tough process also. Yes. So the person who are producing wools, sorry, the person that are working at the such place where the wool production is going on, it is very difficult for them also. There are so many health issues that they face during the wool production. The main is anthrax. What is anthrax? It is a respiratory problem. Okay, it is caused by a bacteria. Okay, how it spreads? It spreads through the dirty wool. Okay, what happened? The dirty wool enters to the person, causing the respiratory disease. It is very fatal, so that the person can also die. Okay, and it is also called Sauter's disease. Anthrax is also called Sauter's disease. It is given in the blue box, occupational hazard, page number 28. You have to do this, means ye yaad rakhna padega aapko, theek hai na? So the next is occupational hazard. What it means, the risk that are faced by the workers when they do work in any industry are called occupational hazards. When they are doing any occupation, they face so many risks. Okay, these risks are termed as occupational hazards. You're getting my point? Now next is, why it hurts when someone pulls his hair, but not when, sorry, there is any person I have imagined about. So this question, what it means that when we pulls hair from the near the skin, it hurts us. But when we do cutting from the bottom side of hair, from the hair, when we go for a haircut, it doesn't hurt us. Why? It also given on page number 28. Yes, Pranvi. Ma'am, please unmute Pranvi.
Ma'am, when we pulls our hair, it comes out from the roots, But when we cut our hair, it doesn't come out of the roots and it doesn't hurt us.
Yes. So the answer is that when hairs are pulled, it hurts our hairs that are attached to the skin. Okay. So the hairs are attached to the skin. Okay. When we pick up a hair, then it also hurts our skin. Okay, but when we go for a haircut, the dead hair is, just 1 minute. Okay, when we are going for a haircut, they don't cut from the root. Okay, yes, वो नीचे से cutting कर देते हैं, so it does not hurt our skin. But when hair are pulled from this part, it is attached to the skin, so we get hurt. Now next is why a cotton garment cannot keep us warm in winter as a woolen sweater does. Anyone knows its answer? Pranvi, kya ho gaya hai turn? Next, Krish, you will answer.
Mamma, cotton garment cannot keep us warm as the winter in winter woolen sweater does, because the woolen sweater has made that it absorbs air and keeps our body warm. But in cotton garment, it does not absorb air but allows air to come inside our body.
Yes, good. So wool is a poor conductor of heat. And also it traps the air between the fibers. Okay, therefore wool keep us warm during the winters. But on the other hand, cotton clothes are thin and they do not have any spaces. Okay, so the cotton does not prevent heat coming out of the body. Okay, so the cotton garment cannot keep us warm in the winter. Now, the whole process I will show in a video, okay? Then it is easy to understand you all also. Just 1 minute, okay? Now, I think it is more clear to you all. Yes? Vanshika, you want to ask something?
आपने कहा कि जो